Hey everyone, welcome back to a new video. And in this video, we're gonna see how we can perform encryption and decryption in our room database to make our data more secure so that no one can access it very easily. So let's see how we can do it. So for that, first go to build.kts file, and on the bottom we have to add this dependency. So these two dependencies for room database, and these two dependencies actually used to perform encryption and decryption logic. Now on the top we have Kotlin KPT plugin. Now come back to your encryption shared preferences package and create one package in it, and the package name in local. Now in this I'm gonna create my database. So database name is app database. This is a class, it's an abstract class. Make sure to extend this class with room database. On the top we have here database annotation. So we'll provide the entities and other information later. For time being, just leave it. Now in this I'm gonna create a companion object. This companion object contain a function, and the function name in get instance. Requirement of this function is context, and the return type of this function would be application database. So simply use return room database builder, pass your context. Next we have to mention our class type, which is application database class.java, and lastly we have to give the name. So for the name I'm using here cryptic database. Now, if you want to perform encryption and decryption, for that we have to use Open Helper Factory. And requirement of this thing is support SQLite Open Helper dot factory type. We will provide this thing later. For the time being, just build this. Okay. So now it's time to provide this information so that the encryption and decryption logic will be performed. For that, on the top, I'm going to create a variable, and this variable is called parse phrase. So with the help of SQLite database get byte. Here I'm gonna use a string. Now this string is very important because it acts as a password, or you can say a key. Using this key, encryption and decryption logic will be performed. So this key is very important. Make sure this key is not accessible by your, you know, normally you cannot access this string. So according to me, you can store this string on the backend, and once user install the application, you can sync those keys into your device, and again, put this information with the help of encrypted shared preferences so that it is not very easily accessible. And after that, once you put this information in your encrypted shared preferences, then you can use in here. For me, I'm simply using this plain string, and here I'm using character array, and this is the type of byte array. Okay, so we are done with our passphrase. Now it's time to create a factory. So with the help of factory, we have here support factory, and the requirement of support factory is passphrase. Simply pass your passphrase, and now it's time to use this factory. Simply use it. Okay, so with the help of get instance, we will receive the instance of our application database. Now it's time to create an entity. So for that we have a data class, and the data class name is fake entity. This will contain an ID, name, type of this thing is integer, and initialize this thing is zero. Next we have a name, type is string. Now I want to make this thing primary key, and also I want this ID to be auto-generate. So I'm using here auto-generate true. Use here entity to define that this is an entity, and we want to store this information in our room database. Now it's time to use it in our data access object. So in this local, I'm gonna create an interface. More specific, this is a fake data access object. On the top, use annotation DAO. And in this DAO, we have only two functions. First function is actually used to perform insertion. And in this, we want to insert our fake entity. On the top, make sure to use annotation insert, and conflict strategies replace. Next, we have query. So in this query, I'm using select all from my fake entity. Suspend function get all fake entities. Return type of this thing is list of fake entity. That's it. Now go back to your application database. In our database, now it's time to provide the information. For the entities, I'm using here my fake entity, type is class. Next we have to provide version. Version is 1, and export schema is false. Now we have to provide this fake data access object implementation. So for that I'm using here abstract function get fake data access object, and return type of this thing is fake data access object. Okay, so we are pretty much done with our application database setup. Now it's time to begin with our composable. So for the composable, I'm gonna create here a composable, and the composable name is main screen. Requirement of this composable is data access object. Type of this thing is fake data access object. Okay, so now here I'm gonna create a column using modifier fill max size. This will contain one more thing. This will contain lazy column. So on the top, I'm gonna show the list of information that we stored in our local database. And in the bottom, we have a text field and a button, which is actually used to put the information in our room database. So for the lazy column, first thing first, I'm gonna use here modifier fill max width. And when it's come to height, I'm gonna use here weight 3f. Now in this, we have to use items. Make sure to use the item that contains item list of type T as a parameter. Okay, so now it's time to get the list of information from our data access object. So for that, on the top, I'm gonna create an state, and the state name is list, mutable state of, initially it is empty list of fake entity. Now in this, we have a launch effect, and I want to execute this launch effect only one time. So due to that reason, key is unit. Now initially I want to update my state with the help of data access object dot get all fake entities. So it will simply update this list. Now it's time to use it. So use your list value, and one by one we will receive our item. So I'm using here text. Next I'm using here material theme, which is coming from our material theme typography headline large. And when it's come to modifier, I'm using here modifier padding horizontally is 16 dp. Let me import this dp. And after that, we have fill max width. Okay, so here we have a problem, and the problem is instead of using our fake entity, use its name. Okay, so that's it for our lazy column. Now on the bottom, I'm gonna create column. Now this time I'm using in this modifier fill max width, but before that, let me make some padding. So padding, I will take horizontally 16 dp. I'm in the vertical arrangement on the center, and its horizontal alignment is also on the center. Okay, now this will contain a text field. So for this text field, we need a state. So on the top, I'm gonna create it. Wall, state name is name. With the help of remember mutable state of, I'm gonna create it. Now it's time to use it. So in place of value, I'm using name dot value. On value change is name dot value. And when anything got updated, it simply update my name state. Now in place of modifier, I'm using first padding horizontally of 16 dp, and after that fill max width. Okay, so just below to it, I'm gonna make some space. So modifier height is 16 dp, and lastly I'm having a button. So this button have a UI, and it says save info. That's it. Now when our user got click this button, we want to save the information in our local database. So for that we require a coroutine, because in data access object, we have suspendable function. So in order to execute suspendable function, we require coroutine. So for that, let's use here scope. With the help of remember coroutine scope, create a scope. Now it's time to use it. In this button, I'm using my scope.launch, and I want to launch this thing in the dispatcher.io because this is a database operation. Okay, so use your data access object.insert. Create a fake entity in place of name. You can use your name dot value. So yeah, that's it. We are pretty much done. Now simply copy this main screen, go to your scaffold and paste in here. In place of modifier, I'm using modifier padding and use this inner padding. Lastly, in place of data access object, we have to create this data access object. So on the top, I'm using private wall data access object by lazy app database dot get instance, requirement is context, so simply pass it. Now we have our get fake data access object function, so use it, it will give us data access object. Now simply pass it in here. Alright, so yeah, we are pretty much done. Now it's time to execute our application. Okay, so here you can see our app is executing. Now I want to store some information. So this is some gibberish information. Okay, so we are not able to see this list information, or the information that we have stored is not visible in our screen. So let's fix this. So for that, when we perform the insertion, just after that, I want to also update my list value state with the help of data access object dot get all fake entities. Okay, so now re-execute your application. Okay, so here you can see this is our information. Now I want to save few more information. Now it's time to see this information is encrypted or not. So for that, go to your device explorer. Just use the same emulator. So this one, Pixel 7a API level 33. Go to data and simply find your package name. So on the bottom, we have encrypted share preferences. Open this thing. We have databases here. Here we have cryptic DB. Now I'm simply using save as to save this information in my desktop. So save as, save it. Okay, now it's time to see the information is encrypted or not. So we have here cryptic database over here. Now I'm gonna open this thing up. You can see all the information is in encrypted way. So by using this approach, you can make your room database more secure so that no one can access your information. So that's all for this video. I hope you like this video. And if you do like this video, comment your opinion. And also, if you want to support me, you can fuel my creativity. Link is in the description box. Good night.